Brenda and Tony were driving along the countryside on a December night. They were on a road trip for 2 weeks as a part of unwinding from a lot of hard work doing up their new house. The plan was to stay in several motels along the way and enjoy the road trip and eating out in diners and enjoying the scenery in between. It was just about getting dark when Brenda was surprised to see a hitchhiker on the road. She said to Tony, "Do you see that?" Tony said, "Yeah, I wonder who is it, way out here." The couple decided to stop, and the hitchhiker said, "Hi there, my name is Paul. I would really love if you could give me a drive just a few miles up the road to the next motel, please. I took the wrong bus and I'm walking miles." Tony said, "Sure, hop in the back." The man's name was Peter. When he was in the back, he began to speak. "I was sure happy to see you guys come along. I must have been walking for miles. I was about to drop unconscious with tiredness from all the walking. And believe me, I'm not fit enough to walk that long. But you guys, where are ye from? Let me guess, the big city. Or maybe you're from the suburbs. Maybe you're the type of people that look down on folk like me." Brenda and Tony found that comment to be strange. Tony said, "Excuse me? Why would we look down on you?" Peter suddenly pulled out a gun and pointed it to Brenda's head and said, "I'll tell you why you look down on me, because I've a gun held to your girlfriend, or is it your wife's head? And you're probably saying to yourself, I'm crazy." Tony said in a voice filled with fear and shock, "What the hell, man? Put away that gun." Peter said, "I do the talking around here. Now keep driving." Brenda began to feel around her pocket for her phone and pretended to sneeze to look down and press 911. When she did, she kept the phone on, hoping it would be traced. Tony said, "Look, man, I don't know what's going on, okay? But I know that we did nothing to you, so please just put the gun away." Suddenly, Peter shouted, "Stop the damn car." Brenda shouted, "Please, no, please stop, just leave us alone." When the car stopped, Peter shot Tony in the back of his head, and he died instantly. The hitchhiker shouted to Brenda, "You're lucky I'm not going to kill you, bitch." And he ran out of the car. Brenda picked the phone up and said to the 911 operator, "Please help me, please, my husband has just been killed by some guy we picked up." 10 minutes later, the police arrived and took a statement from Brenda. Brenda was sitting inside her home that herself and Tony had recently refurbished. There was a noise at the door, and a figure walked into the room. She could see that it was Peter the hitchhiker. He pulled out a gun and pointed at her. Then he smiled and said, "Bang, bang." She smiled back at him and said, "I have your money, and thanks for taking this job. He actually was cheating on me all the while we were doing up our new home." Peter said, "I actually must give you credit for this idea and coming up with the 911 call, etc. But as much as I'd love to stay around for tea, I need to get going, because if your police or neighbours see me, then who knows, tongues might start wagging and they might ask questions." Brenda asked, "What do you mean? How will they trace you to all this? They never even saw your face." Peter said, "I know, but I still have to tie up loose ends." Brenda said, "What do you mean?" Peter said, "Don't worry, it will be over soon." He lifted the gun and shot Brenda in her head. Then he walked into her bedroom and opened up her safe with her own finger he cut off just a minute ago. He was going to just go ahead and murder her husband for $100,000, but she had too much a big mouth and told him about a safe full of diamonds that only her fingerprint would open. He smiled when he looked at all the diamonds. Then suddenly he heard a ticking sound. He wondered what it was. He looked around the room to see. Suddenly all the doors and windows locked. He assumed it was some sort of alarm from the safe being opened at a time that wasn't scheduled. He heard the ticking get louder as he looked under the bed and saw that it was a bomb. From the timer, he saw that it would detonate in 10 minutes. For the next 10 minutes, he looked around for a way out of the house. But when the 10th minute came, he exploded with the house.